마지막으로 즐거웠고 Welcome to the 2021 Graduating Holiday of Puerto Rico. Thank you for joining us here to help celebrate our students' achievements throughout the year. Who I will not perform for us. Year 2.
Emma Hooter will now open today's event.
とてもあのファリカーはあがるるね
いやあうあうえはい
とてもあがるにぽあがるるね
いやあうあうえはい
とてくらをぱいてあがるるね
いやあうあうえはい
えいや
Mihi Tane Mahuta, Kia ora to Fire Steve and Matua Rai, the tutor of Kapaka students. Please stand for our school karakia.
I will be there for 2 weeks. Tihe mauri ora, nau mai haere mai. Ko tainui te waka, ko rangipo te maunga, ko paritu te awa. Ko wharikawa te moana, ko o kautere te kura nei. Tēnā koutou katoa. Kia ora koutou and good afternoon whānau and tamariki. Welcome to our slightly different looking prize giving for 2021. We wish all our whānau were here with us to celebrate, but like we have done for most of this year, we will adapt, persevere, and still provide a special occasion for our tamariki to celebrate what has been a challenging year. These are very strange times we're living in at present. There are many things we previously took for granted that we can't do or have right now. There is something we do have, though, and that's the opportunity to support the resilience of our tamariki, and yes, our own resilience as well. Resilience is the ability to bounce back after challenges and tough times. Despite what some people think, resilience isn't something that just happens or something that children have while others don't. Resilience comes about through experiences that can be learned. Whānau and other adults have an important role in this by providing tamariki opportunities to develop and grow their inner character. Resilience can be made up of a number of parts, one of them being confidence. A belief that things will be okay is important. We need to be able to handle things, and we need to know we can handle things in order to feel confident that we can be resilient when times get tough. We can help children see when they have done well. Praise can be helpful, but only it's important that it's honest and real. We are letting them know that they have things to be confident about. Connection. The sense of connection that tamariki have with their whānau is vital to their resilience. Even times of conflict can contain lots of opportunities for learning. When conflicts are resolved well, this can support a child's resilience. They see that although conflict does happen, there are ways of resolving it without anyone getting hurt. Supportive adults and teachers and staff make all the difference. Character, a sense of right and wrong, helps tamariki to make great choices. Learning the right thing to do and choosing to do it involves understanding the way in which their behaviour affects other people. Find ways our tamariki can think of others and experience the joy this unselfishness brings. Contribution. Children who contribute to the well-being of others are likely to have a sense of purpose. Through contributing, they are increasing their competence, character, and connection to others as well. They are helpful, not helpless, and this increases their resilience. Coping. Healthy ways of coping with stress are an important part of resilience. When adults model positive coping strategy, this is a win-win. We are also showing our tamariki ways to cope with stressful situations. Asking for help when you are genuinely needed is an important part of coping. So, we all have a lot to deal with right now, and this isn't a checklist to measure our performance against. Chances are we're already helping children develop in many of these areas. We all have different strengths and focus on some areas more than others. This is an opportunity to think about other aspects we can support our community with. The pandemic is an opportunity to support our tamariki of any age to strengthen their resilience. This will stand them in good stead as they inevitably come across other challenges in the future. now for some thank yous. I want to extend my gratitude to all our staff and their dedication throughout what has been a tumultuous year. I want to take this moment to acknowledge and to tautoko all our school teachers, our kaiako, and support staff, our kaiawhenua, who have responded to constant changes and demands during the year and for always putting our tamariki first. Your dedication and compassion is why our school maintains a feeling of inclusiveness, but also ensuring your tamariki are safe. A big thank you to Steph, who will be going on maternity leave next March. Thank you for all your mahi this year, Steph. Thank you for being so welcoming and caring to all those who walk through our front door. We can't wait to meet your new addition to the whānau, hopefully born on my birthday. I would like to take this moment to also farewell Bridget and Drew, who are heading away to continue their studies. You have both been huge assets to our school and to our tamariki. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your aroha, and thank you for all the support you have given for all of our tamariki and our staff. Please come up, Drew and Bridget, and accept a little token of our appreciation. Let's give them a huge round of applause. At this time, I'd also like to acknowledge Mrs. Maxine Roberts. It's taken me a little while to get used to Roberts, but I've got it now. Mrs. Roberts joined us in, I believe, about 2016, making the shift from ECE to primary, and luckily to our kura. She has been a dedicated staff member at Aupōtere School. Her leadership, her passion, and enthusiasm has helped develop our learning through play curriculum and guide the positive direction of our junior school. She is a true advocate of our kura, and we are so grateful for her teaching skills and commitment to Aupōtere School. I would like Mrs. Roberts to come up and receive a gift as a mark of respect from our kura and our school community. We hope that you will come and visit us anytime you like. I'm going to do a big cuddle first till my hands get full.
Lucky
you
only lives down the road, isn't it?
And some
places.
And we will see Miss Roberts very soon. She only lives down the road, that's right. Hands and is well supported by our dedicated Board of Trustees. To our Board of Trustees, Steve, Phil, Hannah, Anton and Mr. Shields, you are a great team to work for and show a real passion for the direction of our school and the achievement of our tamariki. So thank you very much for your input throughout this time as well. It is also time to farewell our year 8s. miss these guys. As they head off to the next stage of their lives, we will miss them, but it is time for you guys to go. We hope that you will take with yourselves the essence of what being a good citizen is, so that you may continue to grow, be great role models, and give back to your peers and your community. We wish you all well, and we hope that you each make contact with us in the future to let us know how you are all getting on. We wish you all the very best. Finally, to all our tamariki, you have all showed tremendous resilience, each in your own unique way. We are very proud of the way you have handled the many interruptions of our year, the cancellations, the postponements. You have all showed perseverance, kindness, and strive to be the best no matter what. Be proud of what you have all achieved this year. Enjoy your holidays, recharge your batteries, and be safe. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Thank you.
Yasmin, India, and Molly will now present their Year 8 Leavers speech.
Kia ora, my name is India, and my name is Yasmin. We have been at Opotiri School since we were 5 years old. We would like to say a big thank you to all of the people and teachers who have helped us be the people we are today. And we are going to miss you all so much. And now we would like to share some core memories from over the years. There are a lot of things that we did when we were little, but one of my faves was the Year 3-4 MasterChef. I remember that I made some sort of samosa, and Yaz made something with lavender and yogurt. We never won any trophies, but we had tons of fun. One of my favourite memories at Opotiri School was the 2017 talent show. Maya and I planned for weeks and weeks earlier what we were going to present. We were going to sing, and of course we just had to make our own song. We called it Walks and Climbs. We also had it planned out that we were going to have matching outfits. So here we were turning up to school with our matching colourful jumpsuits and our hair tied up in pigtails. Even though we didn't end up winning anything, which I think was really unfair by the way, we did get a free one. Our first teacher was Miss H. Here are some of the little things that she did that made our first year so fun. Every week, only one very special person got picked to sit in the magical tiara chair. She would also bring us envelopes that our own special fairies had written for us each week. I'm pretty sure Yasmin's fairy was named Moonlight and mine was called Periwinkle. Every morning, we would take turns choosing songs. We would always choose Let It Go by Queen Elsa or the Soul Sister song. Now, don't even get us started on our junior self nicknames. Yazzie Banana, Indie Apple, My My Mango, and Maisie Strawberry. They were the nicknames we made up for ourselves when we were about 6. They kind of just stuck around until we were 10. Thank you, Opotiri School, for always giving us heaps of opportunities. We have loved being a part of this amazing school, and we will miss everyone next year. Hai re ra, and Merry Christmas.
Tēnā koutou katoa, ko Māori Takumi. I'm the 5th generation to attend Opotiri. And my whānau have been here from the very beginning. So as you can imagine, it's not just a kura to me. There's much more than that. When people ask me what school I go to, I'm proud to say Opotiri. I have mixed feelings about leaving, but I can say one thing. I never miss an opportunity, and within my last 8 years there have been so many. The journey started when I was 4 years old. I'd come for visits with bears, and then with my first 2 weeks of being at school, I went on a whole school trip to Auckland Zoo. It was a dream way to start my next 8 years of life. In my time at school, I've had camps at Kali Tatsun's, Rotorua, Oramantu, Otrahonga, and many local ones. I've represented my kura at Thames Valley, Hei Waikato, organised bomb competitions, had a MasterChef in class, been to plenty of kapaka events, speaks, competitions, expeditions, event races, the list could go on all afternoon. I've made friendships that will last for life and memories that I'll keep forever. Thank you to Wider Bina Charlotte for being the best friends I could ever ask for. Thank you for making my last year so fun. Mrs. Wall, thank you for teaching me math in a way that was so fun and made me love it. Mrs. Wiley, thank you for being so kind, caring, nurturing, and my mum at school. Mrs. Hearing, thank you for letting us be so creative and helping us find our strengths. Mrs. Kennings, thank you for all your hard work and time and effort you put into Kabaka. And Mrs. Berg, thank you for always just being there when I needed you. Mrs. Reesing, thank you for finding me new opportunities, I thank you. Bridget, thank you for making my last year so much more entertaining. And Mrs. Witt, I had you for 4 years, and though that was a rocky start, I respect you beyond words. Your inquiry, knowledge, and passion is something that I'll use for the rest of my life. And thank you for pushing us so hard to be the best we can possibly be. Matua, your mentor in every Thursday has always been a highlight of my week. The opportunities you have given us is unforgettable. I don't think people realise just how lucky we are, so thank you. Mr. Shields, I hope you've enjoyed your first year at Aukura, and good luck for your journey. And lastly, Mr. Lee, not so funny dad. Thank you for everything you do and have done. As a leaving year, I'm proud to say I know my strengths, I know my weaknesses, and I know exactly who I am. All of you sitting down here, please make sure you take every opportunity, make memories, make mistakes, and enjoy every moment. Never forget, we are one and we'll always be fine. Ka kite.
Mana Award goes to Kensler. And the Four Mana Award goes to Brody. And the Year Five Mana Award goes to Kiara.
Mana Award goes to Aaliyah. And And the Year 8 Mana Award goes to Wairaroa. The Year 7 Whanaunatanga Award goes to Ben. And the Year 8 Whanaunatanga Award goes to India. The Year 7 Manaakitanga Award goes to Jackson. And the Year 8 Manaakitanga Award goes to Kira.
get the Potomac certificate. These are for students who have consistently throughout the year shown commitment to learning and striving for excellence. They have navigated the steps of learning and achievements with growth mindset.
The year one, Potomac goes to Moana.
The year three Potama award goes to Hazel. Year 6, Savannah.
The Year 7 Potama Award goes to Felix.
Please make your way to the stage to make the leaving presentation to our 10 year old students who are moving on to high school.
Thank you, Marley. Kira, would you like to come down, please? Yasmin? Marley? Myra? India? Elliot, Wairaroa, Sirius, Maya, and I'll just acknowledge Fleur, who's not with us.
I'm
This award is for the student or students who show the most growth and interest in tapa Māori, te reo Māori and tikanga Māori at Aupatiri School. This year it is a combined award and it is awarded to Wairarua, Māori and India. Also their leadership, where they came in and they taught Pūriri a whole waiata with actions. So you've done a terrific job, you three. Thank you very much.
Can the house captains please come up on stage? Ms. Lee will now present the house captains with their certificates and announce the house chair for the meeting.
Deputy House Captain Sirius from Paritu, Deputy House Captain Aaliyah from Paritu, and House Captain Porikawa, we have Deputy House Captain Maya and Felix, and then our House Captain Kira. For Rangipo, we had Māori as the Deputy House Captain, and we had a shared captain role between India and Wairarua. And for Tauta, we had Deputy House Captain Ezra, Deputy House Captain Lila, and House Captain Sky Parker. Not Sky. Not yet Skyler. Have the house shield, something that you have all been working for all year. It was a very tightly contested race, and I'm just going to get on with it because we're running out of time. In first place, drum roll please. Congratulations to Tawa Tawa. A little surprise, I see. Give them a big round of applause. Thank you.
Shields will now present the 2021 leadership statement.
These awards are for students who have shown outstanding leadership throughout the year. These students have the ability to lead or to step back when things are going well. These people are well respected by staff and students because of their humour, good values, and because of the respectful manner in which they treat everyone else. Felix. Yasmin. Wairoa. Sky. Sirius. Ollie. Millie. Maya. Marley. Lila. Karen. India. Ezra and Aaliyah. This cup is for one of these outstanding leaders who over the course of the year has gone above and beyond. This year's winner is Marley Jacobs.
These awards are for a junior and senior student who consistently display high levels of courtesy and give service to the school. They interact positively with all ages and are able to stand their ground with their peers, make wise choices for the greater good. And the Junior Citizenship Cup is for Eden Stewart. Yay.
This cup is for a student who shows outstanding commitment in, for, and at
Miss Riesling will now present the cup for the most improved student in the school for 2021.
This award is for a student who has shown a significant accelerated improvement in their effort, learning and achievement. This year, the most improved student award goes to JT. Excellent standard
and represented our school at Thames Valley level and won. The senior speech cup this year goes to India Kenny.
This award is for someone who consistently displays their adventure learning competencies throughout the year. And the award for this year goes to Felix Lloyd.
For a student who has shown all-round ability across all areas of school life. This includes academic, sporting, cultural, citizenship, and leadership. This year's Points Cup goes to India Kennings.
Thank you. much for watching. Merry Christmas and have a great holiday. Keep safe and look after each other. Noho oro mai.